Another physical quantity that we will talk about is force. We would say about force that it is the mutual action of objects. We are trying to measure this action, so it is a physical quantity. We denote force with the capital letter F. The basic unit of force is the Newton, according to the physicist who dealt with force. We determine the magnitude of the force using a gauge called a force meter. Because we are trying to measure how one object affects another object. In other words, as it affects it, force is a very significant physical quantity. We will show how one object exerts a force on another object. We have two objects. One object is the crane and the other is its load. When a crane lifts a load, it exerts a force on it. However, the load also exerts a force on the crane, because if the load were heavy and the ropes were weak, the load could break the ropes and fall. It's similar when you lift a barbell in the gym. By lifting, you exert force on the barbell, but the barbell also exerts force on your muscles, which you feel as they tighten. Now let's look at some examples of force. As the first example of a force, we will mention the magnetic force. This force manifests itself in such a way that two magnets attract if they have opposite poles to each other, or repel if they have opposite poles to each other. Both magnets therefore interact with each other. Another example is electric power. This force manifests itself in the way that two electrically charged particles act on each other. Again, the two particles attract if they are oppositely charged, or attract each other if they are positively charged. For example, we can charge the hair by rubbing it with a comb. The hair is then electrically attracted to the comb and vice versa, whereby the comb and the hair exert an electrical force on each other. Another example of a force can be the gravitational force, which manifests itself in the way that two objects of arbitrary mass attract each other. The planet Earth attracts man with its gravitational force, but man also attracts the Earth with its gravitational force, although it is not so noticeable anymore. Another example of a force can be a mechanical force, which manifests itself in such a way that two objects cause a change in the movement or shape of another object. An example could be just lifting dumbbells in the gym, transferring a load with a crane, or turning, for example, a jar lid. Now let's talk about how we measure force. We measure it using a force meter, which works as follows. The load cell contains a spring, which is a separate coiled metal wire that can be stretched. This spring is stretched due to the force acting on the force meter, and thus we get the resulting units in newtons on the scale of the force meter. For example, if we want to measure the gravitational force acting on a weight of 100 grams, then we attach the weight to the force meter and let the weight hang freely. In this case, when the weight weighs 100 grams, the load cell would measure the force acting on the weight as 1 newton. This tells us how a spring force meter works. There are other, for example, digital force meters that work on a different principle. Now let's talk about the areas in which the action of force must be taken into account. In the case of force, both the size and the direction of its action are important. The first example is the construction industry. A construction designer who proposes the construction of bridges, buildings, or even tunnels must know what forces are acting on the proposed structure and also how long the structure can withstand these forces. If he gets it wrong or makes a mistake in the design, for example by misjudging the forces, then the bridge or building can fall. Therefore, it is important for the designer to know what forces are acting on the bridge, and to check over time whether the bridge or building is still in such a condition that it can withstand the effects of these forces. Another example is the design of machines and equipment, where it is also necessary to know the effect of forces. It can be brakes on cars, where the brakes work on the principle of frictional force, or many useful machines, especially in the construction industry, such as a bulldozer, excavator, or crane, which help us with the application of greater mechanical force. Another example is transportation. In transport, we can mention the movement of vehicles, planes, ships, and other means of transport, which is based on the action of forces. Propulsion, friction, and aerodynamic forces affect the speed, direction, and movement of these vehicles. Another example is energy. In addition to the already mentioned electrical power, which can be created with the help of electricity, power is also important in the production of electrical energy. Production involves the use of different kinds of forces, such as mechanical force in turbines or electromagnetic forces in generators. Another example can be sports. Athletes often do not calculate strength in any way, however, they work with strength intuitively. A tennis player tries to hit the ball so hard that it hits the boundary of the court. He must not exert too much force on the ball, otherwise the ball would fly off the court, and at the same time he must not exert too little force on it so that it flies over the tennis net. Athletes involved in throwing a javelin or shot put try to give the deal as much force as possible, but in addition to force, they also have to correctly determine the direction of the throw, so that the javelin or shot goes as far as possible. Finally, let's recall what we said in this video. We said that force is a physical quantity, which we denote by the letter F, the basic unit is the Newton, and we measure it using a force meter. There are several types of forces such as magnetic force, electric force, gravitational force, or mechanical force. We can use the physical quantity of force in many areas such as construction, machine construction, transport, energy, or sports. That's it for this video. If you want to support this channel, don't forget to subscribe.